हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू दिस चैनल। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग विद आवर मेन कंटेंट, लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस अबाउट मी। माई सेल्फ गोपाल, करंटली ऑन माई वे विद बीटेक इन द फील्ड ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी। आई एम गुड इन डिजाइनिंग वेब एप्लीकेशंस यूजिंग जेंगो एंड पीएचपी। कमिंग टू आवर टुडेज टॉपिक, दिस वीडियो कंटेन द बेसिक प्रोग्राम्स दैट एवरी प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज लर्नर शुड स्टार्ट विथ। लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ आवर फर्स्ट प्रोग्राम। आवर फर्स्ट प्रोग्राम इज टू फाइंड वेदर द गिवन नंबर इज Armstrong number or not. First, we will go through the logic and we will implement our logic through the code. So, any number, if we want to determine whether it is an Armstrong number or not, then our logic is sum of cubes of digits in a number must be equal to the number. So, for example, let us see an example. We will take the 153 as an example. So, sum of cubes of the digits means 1 cube plus 5 cube plus 3 cube. That's equals to 1 plus 125 plus 127 equals to 153. So, sum of the cubes of digits is equals to the number. So, 153 is an Armstrong number. Let's go with other example. Let me take the number 21. So, digits are 2 and 1. 2 cube plus 1 cube equals to 9, which is not equals to 21. So 21 is not an Armstrong number. Let's start building the logic. Initially, I take the variable s and assign it a value to 0 to sum up our values every time. So I took the example as 153. So to split the digits in the number, I am dividing it with the 10 and taking the remainder. So 153 when divided by 10, it gives the remainder as 3. After that, to reduce the number for our next iteration, I am taking its coefficient. So 153 by 10 equals to 15. Every time we are getting the digit separately, so I am adding its cube to our s variable. S equals to initially our s value is 0. So s equals to 0 plus 27. After that, we are taking the quotient to calculate with our next iteration. So 15 then divided by 10, we are getting the remainder as 5. So cubing the 5 and adding with the previous s value gives our result s equals to 27 plus 125. And we are taking the quotient 15 by 10 equals to 1 to our next iteration. 1 when divided by 10 gives the remainder 1. So adding up this cube of this value to our s. Next, we are reducing our n. When divided by 10, it gives the 0. So it is our n. Let us implement the logic through our code. So initially, I am taking input from the user as it is the integer input, int of input of. So next, I am assigning this value to the another variable for purpose of future use and initializing the s to 0. So I am using the while loop to iterate. I am adding the remainder, I mean the cube of the remainder to the s every time. After that, I am reducing my n value. So at the end of the n equals to 0, it will get out from the while loop. And now we have to check whether our sum is equals to our number or not. If the number is equals to the sum, then it is the Armstrong number, or else it is not an Armstrong number. Let's save this code and run it. So we give the input as 153. It is showing as the it is an Armstrong number. We will check with then another input value. So now I am taking the value as 356, which is not an Armstrong number. Let's move to another question. Reverse of a number, that is, user gives the input number, then it should result out the reverse of that number. In this example, we take 1234 as example. So output should be 4321. Coming to the logic, for every iteration till n not equals to 0, get the last digit and add it to the s, which is multiplied by 10. And in the next step, we reduce our n value for the use of next iteration. So after completion of our first iteration, our s value is 4. Implement the same logic for every iteration. So our s value gets changes to s is equals to 4, s is equals to 43. And in the next iteration, s is equals to 432, and at final iteration, s is equals to 4321. Let us start implementing the reverse of the number with our program. So initially, I am taking an integer input. And s is equals to 0. And while n not equals to 0, s equals to s into 10 plus n mod 10. So adding the remainder to the s into 10. And in the next step, we are reducing our n value. So finally, we are printing the output. We will save it and run. I am giving the input as 1234. So our output is reverse of the number is 4321. Let us check it with the another example, like 7864. So the reverse of the number is 4687. That's it for the video. If you like the video, please like the video and share with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel.